the creation of Mistral was driven by an intention to make the technology more widely available. Revolution that we're all building together doesn't end up being controlled by three US players. Because if that's the case, the digital divide that we've been observing is just going to continue to grow. The chance we have is that this is not such a costly technology to make. The approach we took, since we want to promote a more decentralized approach, we promoted open source models. And that, more importantly, they contributed to lowering the barrier of entrance to making interesting technology on top of it. It's much easier if you have access to very good open source models, because you start from a certain level of intelligence and you can bring your own expertise. The biggest risk we have today is a form of concentration of power. We've been showing through actual achievements that the benefits of being more open, of being more decentralized, of working with everybody in the world were actually super important and shouldn't be given up for risk reasons, I would say. You need to come up with automated way of evaluating. You need to come up with processes to get humans to evaluate the technology. Today, the technology is working well enough on certain use cases. We should deploy it to population. They should adopt it. That's very important. We can split responsibilities in between industries and governance. The first, our responsibility would be to make it cheap and to make it controllable and private. Mm-hmm. And I'll dive into that. And I think the responsibility of government should be to make it widespread, so focus on education, focus on public services, focus on healthcare, and make sure that there's no regulatory capture. And so just diving it a little deeper, how do we make it cheap? So you make algorithmic changes to have the smallest models possible. You work on the software, you work with hardware makers, you actually work with new hardware makers to reduce the energetical cost and to make sure that you're leveraging the hardware as much as possible. So that's a software, that's a lot of R&D to do, and that's something we've been investing on. What something that we've released in particular are edge models, so models that can be deployed on device. If you do that, you're alleviating the cost that is carried by data centers. That's one of the approaches that you can have. And then when it comes to making it controllable, this is all, everything related to being open source, taking the software and putting it in the hands of our customers so that they make their own custom AI systems, and we do disappear from the loop and we ensure that they have full privacy. Actually, that's very important because we need to reduce the interdependencies we have, because we do live in a world where interests are not always aligned, and we think that to build resilience in every country should have its own AI strategy. Everyone in a school use this tool to learn faster. So there's a lot of UX aspects also. It's not only about software, mm-hmm. deep software, mm-hmm. science. It's also about the interface, the design. And the design needs to be adapted to the different parts of the world in which you are, because it's different languages. Sometimes you read from left to right, from right to left. The decentralization is not only about the models. It's also about the way you distribute it within different countries.